Episode 22, Evacuation. In the control tower on Sorna, the commander was on the radio. The three control workers in the room were listening to his conversation with the Navy.
Our radar is telling us that a ship has left the island headed north. What about our orders? Wasn't clear.
I told them to stay, but the captain wouldn't listen.
Well, we'll send a cruiser after them. They'll regret their choice soon enough. Listen, the helicopters are on their way and should arrive at your location in several minutes. We don't want to lose time on the evacuation. Have your men standing by at the landing site.
Some of our men are still missing. They're headed back here.
Damn it! Get them to hurry!
We lost communication with them.
How incompetent. Never mind. Try and reach them, or else we'll consider them lost in action.
You can't do that!
Oh, I assure you, we can. What?
The captain had turned his attention to someone on the ship. Silence for a while. Then...
What's this about a family on the island? The river?
Yes, our men were after them, trying to retrieve them.
Then for their sake, I hope your men will be with them. We have a lawyer here saying he's representing a Dr. Alan Grant who's there on the island. We need to move the fleet for their position to pick them up. Which river?
Last we heard, they were at the aviary, so... I guess that means they must be on Canal Hondo. South side.
We'll pick them up. Just get your men ready for extraction.
The captain broke the connection. The commander now looked worried, feeling helpless. In the distance, they heard the army helicopters approaching, seeing them coming into view over the jungle treetops.
Alright, you heard it. Let's get ourselves and the others to the extraction point. You three, get Ray and Ryan ready for transport, on a stretcher if necessary. I'll shut down everything in here, and we'll get Dr. Wu and Dr. Harding after.
Henry Wu was in Raymond's room, standing next to his bed, preparing a needle and tube to give Raymond a cure that had worked so well on the animals. Yeah. He emptied the complete sample he had on him into a syringe. On the bed, Raymond was sweating, laying still, softly groaning at times.
If this works as well as it did on the animals, you should feel better soon.
Henry Wu rolled up Raymond's sleeve and pushed the needle in, pushing the complete content of the syringe into Raymond's bloodstream. The door opened and two of the control workers came inside, holding a stretcher to transport Raymond outside, ready for the helicopters.
Dr. Wu, oh good, we found you. We need to move now for extraction.
You and the doctor take Raymond out. I'll go help Mark getting Ryan.
Sure, you can help me, right, doctor?
As the first control worker leaves, the other prepares the stretcher for Raymond.
What's going on?
We need to move him outside. We're evacuating.
Then I've got to get my data and the cure. I need to take those with me.
Sure. After we get him out, you can go get your data.
Doubtful, Henry Wu looked outside, through the small window. In the meantime, the control worker had the stretcher ready, wanting to move Raymond onto it.
Come on, Doc. You can't leave me hanging here.
Wu decided to help, and together they moved Raymond from the bed onto the stretcher. On the other side of the village, the commander now entered Wu's office, looking around. The external hard drive laying on Wu's desk, next to a tube with 408B on it, ready to be taken on evacuation.
Hello? Dr. Wu? Dr. Harding?
Seeing no one in the office, he moved to the soundproofed connection to the animal quarters. He opened the next door. Chittering, growling, and other heavy animal sounds came his way from the gloomy room.
Hello?
Yes, Commander?
Looking to his left, the commander found Jerry Harding, sitting at his desk, back in his good mood, now surrounded by the animals that started to get better. Rather uncomfortable in the presence of the animals, he looked at Harding, relieved.
Ah, Dr. Harding. Thank God.
What is it? Have you heard from Sarah? Is she alright?
No. Yes. I don't know. I need you to come with me to the extraction point. They're about to evacuate us.
Has Sarah returned?
No, not yet.
Then they can't evacuate us yet, can they?
They'll probably pick her up with that family. They're sending a team to pick them up from Canal Hondo. Please, come with me, Doctor.
An uneasy feeling crept over Harding, and he thinks for a moment. To get the commander off his back, he finally answers.
Alright. I'll be out momentarily. Just need a few things. You go ahead. I'll be there in a few seconds.
Okay.
Grateful to be able to leave the room, the commander moves for the door that leads outside. Just before exiting, he turns.
Have you seen Dr. Wu, by any chance?
Jerry looks up.
He's seeing Raymond.
Oh, good. Thanks.
And he leaves the room to the yard outside, where the helicopters were already coming down through the gate in the roof, only just fitting. Down below, two of the control workers are standing ready with Ryan, who's still looking ill but standing, strong enough to walk. In that moment, Dr. Wu comes out with the other control worker, carrying the stretcher with Raymond on it. The helicopters touch down next to Raymond's helicopter, and three soldiers jump out, while an officer stays at the entrance. The soldiers start helping the control workers to get the sick inside, including Raymond with the help of Dr. Wu. When Henry Wu turns to get his sample, a US Air Force soldier stops him, grabbing his arm.
I'm sorry, sir. We're going! Get inside!
I need to get the cure!
Then Henry decides it's no use explaining. He pulls his arm free and tries to run for it, but he is tackled by the other soldier. The officer nods to a third, who then knocks out Henry Wu, and he stops struggling with the other soldier.
Get him inside.
The soldiers bind his hands and bring him to a chair in the helicopter, strapping him in. The commander walks towards them.
Dr. Harding is coming in a moment!
Suddenly they hear the honking of a car horn from outside the wall coming closer, until the Humvee with Sarah and Tim is entering the compound through the open gate.
Well, aren't they looking just in time?
The commander is looking out at them.
Where are the other cars?
Sarah stopped the Humvee next to the helicopters, got out, and moved to the back to help Tim with Billy.
Who's that?
One of your visitors. We got him out of the water at the aviary. He's hurt.
Just one? Where are the others?
Sarah and Tim move with Billy to the helicopter and hand Billy over to two soldiers, who take him to the second helicopter.
Alright, take your seat, everyone. We're moving.
Sarah gets a look inside and sees Henry Wu coming too.
Where's my father?
In there! He said he'd be coming soon!
Looking at the animal quarters, they now see six young Gallimimus running through the door. Scared and disoriented, they flee, spreading out and running past the helicopters on all sides, and one even through the middle. Then they flock back together on the other side and run for the gate.
What?
Dad?
Then follow the two young Triceratops, coming out of the animal quarters, moving around howling. Sarah moves for the compound. The one soldier is blocked by the commander, and the other two are getting Billy inside. No one to stop her. Sarah!
Get back here! Get inside!
Tim looks at Henry, who moves his head up, signaling to go after Sarah. Tim moves to go after her. Commander moves in, keeping the soldier blocked as Tim moves to get Sarah. Henry shouts after him.
Get the disc from my office, and the sample! I need the sample!
As soon as the commander is in, the officer looks out.
Well, they brought this on themselves. Close the doors. We're moving.
Soldiers close the doors.
Wait! You can't leave them!
I assure you I can. We've been very clear on this from the moment we first contacted you. No delays.
Tim looks back as the doors close, and the helicopter starts to take off.
What? You're just gonna leave us here?
From the animal quarters now comes the Clatuses, come scattering out, finding their way to the gate, and away from the village into the jungle beyond. Next follows a young Pachycephalosaurus, running out confused. Sarah jumps aside as she moves in on the building.